Hello everybody, this is Timmyfan, and well, this video was kind of inspired by a few friends. I just want to describe how it is I can get struck by so many trolls in a day and still manage to keep smiling and laughing and just not let them get to me at all. And most of the time, I gotta say, I do wind up laughing at them, and I've taken to putting ha 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 on the screen. And usually that means I am laughing at them. Because I love, first of all, how they get so angry at me. And second of all, how they hate me so much. And most of them are vegan fanatics, which I don't care to have associating with me anyways. So, the more they hate me, the better I feel. So, I just want to show you how I can tolerate, you know, and even laugh at and relish comments like these and still keep a smile on my face and stay happy. Yeah, those were some bad comments, and those were comments that I've received recently, most of them, again, by vegan fanatics. Well, there's this article in Woman's World, and I want to show this to you. For those of you who get struck by trolls, and they tend to let you down and feel bad about yourself, there's some pretty helpful hints in here. Hints that I've known all my life and have followed, but the fact that they're in print here really makes me feel comfortable. It's all in the mind. Mix negativity with visualization. Visualize somebody that you love, which is something that I always do. I visualize all the fun times I've had with all my friends, my family. Oh, and there's one thing that absolutely no troll can take away from me. My memories of meeting Tim Ferriss. Now, Tim Ferriss is my most favorite celebrity. He is the guitarist for INXS, which is my most favorite band of all time. So, every time I get struck by a troll, one of the things that I think about was meeting him. Now, how many people can actually say that they have met their favorite celebrities and that celebrity was so nice and kind to them, as Timmy was, and he even called me sweetheart? Of course, he does that with all his fans. But still, how many people have met their favorite celebrities and can actually say that? For vegan fanatics, it's that Gary Yourofsky guy. And he's ugly as shit, so I don't want to meet him. Plus, he and I have nothing in common except a love for animals. So they may have met him, but I'm like, so what? Tim is much more handsome, and he was much more fun to meet, and he's funny. He's real funny. And he is genuinely from the heart funny. And I even have these pictures to commemorate my meetings with Tim Ferriss. Yep, those are things that no troll can take away from me. Absolutely no troll. And no matter how bad they try to make me feel, all I have to do is remember Timmy, and I feel good. So that's one thing that they say in here to get rid of the negative feelings. The second thing, ask yourself this question. What's easy for me that's difficult for everyone else? Now, there's something that I can do that none of these trolls can do. As a matter of fact, most of them don't even have videos up of themselves. And I'm not saying my videos are my greatest accomplishment. This is my greatest accomplishment. My Metazoic checklist. Look at all those pages. Nobody could do this like I can. And that is the one thing in this world that I am extremely proud of. That's the one thing that, again, no troll can take that away from me. That's something that I did over years. Probably more years than most of those damn trolls have been alive. I've been working on this since 1992, and I'm extremely proud of the progress I've made on my Metazoic site. And no troll can figure that out. That's something that is unique to me, the Metazoic site. So yeah, that's one thing that they can't take away from me. And it isn't just the website. The website I've only been working on since 2004. But the Metazoic project has been going on since 1992, and I'm extremely proud of it. I'm proud of all the progress. I mean, look at this. This is an entire checklist. A checklist, mind you, of species that I myself created for this world. Most trolls barely understand the concept of life, let alone the concept of science and evolution. They pretend they do, but they really don't. And my Metazoic project has been praised from science communities all over the world. Not just science communities, but scientists, some world-renowned. As a matter of fact, I referred Dougal Dixon, who is the father of modern speculative evolution. I referred him to the site, and he and I are friends now. And who would ever thought that someone like me could become friends with someone as famous as Dougal Dixon? That's something that other speculative evolutionists only wish for. That's not the kind of thing that happens to people like them. That's the kind of thing that happens to people like me, who are dedicated to their work and devoted. So that's one thing no troll can take away from me, no matter how hard they try. And another thing here says, bring out your inner coach and quash your inner critic. Okay, I am my own worst critic. I always look at a comment and I say, is this something that I normally say about myself? Yeah. Usually it is. I mean, I admit it, I'm fat. It's like, so what? You gotta be your own worst critic. So, try thinking of it that way. And then saying, instead of fat, I say I'm puffy. And I am. I mean, this is all soft flab. So, yeah, that's the way I look at it. I look at the negative in a positive way, and that helps a lot. And this thing about committing suicide because of things that people online say to you or about you, it isn't worth it. Just remember these three simple steps that I gave you from here, and I urge everyone to check these out. This is from July 25th of this year. And I encourage everybody to check these out because they're wonderful. I love them. I collect them. So I've been reading up a lot on these. And those are some of the things that you could do when you're attacked online or even in real life. You know, think of those things. Don't let what somebody else says get to you. And believe me, as far as committing suicide, there are far worse things that can happen to you than worrying about what some teenager or some 20-year-old, oh yeah, and vegan fanatics, don't forget them, shits on you about, you know. There's lots worse things than that, so I just don't let it Anyway, that's all I've got to say on this subject. So, you know, keep those smiles going. And don't let the trolls get to you, you know. Just don't worry about them. Just think about all the good things that you're good for, and what they say will just flutter off into oblivion. So this is Timmy-Fan signing off. Good night, everybody.